come it by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Divine Touch International Ministry presents Pastor John Okene, a servant of God with integrity, anointed with a healing, deliverance, teaching and preaching ministry. As you listen to this message, may you be positively impacted and empowered by the living word of God. Open up your heart and receive divine touch.
Oh, hands and give him praise and say, Father, we just appreciate you. Just open your mouth, appreciate him. It's worthy to be praised. It's worthy to be glorified. Is the I am that I am, Jehovah Nissi. Is the one that ordained us to be here today, that made today to change someone's life. Just open your mouth and thank him because it's wonderful. Thank him because it's excellent. Thank him because it's glorious. Thank because it's dependable. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' marvelous name, we worship. Now quickly, we will take some prayer points before we go to the word. In Zechariah chapter 1 verse 17 precisely, and then you begin to go to 21, the Bible says that what happened, he said to Jerusalem, he said, Jerusalem, through prosperity, Jerusalem shall be spread abroad. It means the desire of God for you to be well known is true prosperity. But the Bible says that what happened, that when they begin to look around, they discover that what happened, they were not prospering. And they ask themselves the question, why are we not prospering? All of a sudden, the Lord opened the eyes of Zacharias. And Zacharias saw four horns. And these horns were so wicked and rugged. And then Zechariah asks, what is these four horns? He said, these four horns have been ordained to scatter. Anytime they gather, it scatters. Anytime they gather, it scatters. And he said, secondly, the horn has prevented them from lifting up their heads. It means it brought shame to them. They are always bending their heads down. I want to announce to someone here today, maybe you are in this place and you have been doing your business. The more you try to gather, the more you are not seeing the money. The more you try to gather, the more it scatters. I prophesy to you in the name of Jesus Christ, as you say loud, amen, whatever that is scattering your finance, God will scatter by fire. I say God will scatter by fire. Now if your amen is louder than your neighbor, God will locate your stone now. If you jump up and say better amen, your matter will be settled. 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 Somebody holler fire. Now he says to lift up their heads. They find it difficult to lift up their heads. Shame comes to them. What is it that has brought you shame? You are always bending your head. You look at your mate that you started together with. You started with them. You went through your normal, you know, service. You served. And they settled both of you. But look at your mate. Your mate has gone ahead. You are far below. You are burying your head in shame. It is because of the ministry of the satanic arms. I want to congratulate you today, because that nonsense has just come to an end in the name of Jesus. The good news is this. The Bible says that all of a sudden, he saw the carpenters. And the carpenters were the angels, are the angels of God. They appeared in the scene and they begin to destroy the horns. Begin to destroy the horns. I pray for you today. Every horn from your father's house or your mother's house or from what around you that is responsible for what you are going through, as you say amen, they shall be scattered by fire. Now lift up and say, my father, my father, my father. As I begin to pray, every satanic horn gathering because of me, either from my father's house or my mother's house, in the name of Jesus, scatter by fire. Scatter, 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 scatter. Lift up your voice and talk to God. Yakaraba soko robo bo bo bo. Mandela santaya. Masantaraba. Rimo santaraba, santaraba, santaya. Begin to scatter them. Begin to scatter the horns. Begin to scatter the horns. Every satanic horns, they have been lifted up against you. Scatter by fire. Scatter by fire. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. You are going to say, my Father, my Father. Any power that has vowed that I will gather, but I will not see what I'm gathering. What are you waiting for? In the name of Jesus, cast fire, cast fire, cast fire. Open your mouth and talk to God. Release the fire. They say you will gather, but you will not see what you are gathering. You labor, not see your labor. Release fire upon them. That nonsense will come to an end. That nonsense will come to an end. Lift up your hands and talk to God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now you are going to open your mouth and talk to God. The Bible says he comes to scatter. Why? For some certain persons, the power says, listen to me, they will struggle, but what happened? They will never see the fruit of their labor. Hello? Every power that says you will be sweating, you will sweat and sweat and sweat and sweat, and at the end of the day, there will be no result. May the fire of God consume them in Jesus' name. Lift up your hands and say, my father, as I pray now, in the name of Jesus, any power that says I will struggle without result, you are a liar. Cast fire. Cast fire. Cast fire. Open your mouth and talk to God. Do that for the next 1 minute. Receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. Receive fire. Talk to God. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Now lift up your two hands. You are going to cry concerning these hands. Say, oh ye my hands. Oh ye my hands. Oh ye my hands. Hear the word of the Lord. Every cause of doubt shall not excel. Upon these hands, in the name of Jesus, break by fire. Break by fire. Break by fire. Open your mouth and talk to God. Every cause of doubt shall not excel. There has been released upon these hands that no matter what I do, I will not excel. I break that curse. I break that curse. I break that curse. Open your mouth and talk to God. Lift up your voice. The Bible said in Genesis 49, he said to him, thou shalt not excel. Unstable as water. Thou shalt not excel, Reuben. Break that curse that says you will not excel. These your hands are ordained to excel. These your hands are ordained to prosper. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, all ye my hands, hear the word of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, I command you, starting from now, begin to prosper. Begin to prosper. Begin to prosper. Begin to prosper. Open your mouth and talk to God. I command you, begin to prosper. Oh my hands, oh my hands, oh my hands. I hear the word of God. Prosper. 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 Talk to God this morning. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Without wasting time, I'll be talking about from sunset to sunrise. From sunset to sunrise. Now, I'll be taking my text from the book of Genesis, chapter 32. Genesis chapter 32. I will read from verse 31 because of our time. Genesis 32, 31. I read quickly. In Genesis chapter 32, verse 31. There was a man called, you all know him, Jacob. The Bible says in 31, okay, and as he passed over to Peniel, the sun rose upon him, and he hurt upon his thighs. The son that was down before, the son rules. I pray for someone here today. If your son has gone down, if you say better amen, may your son rise again. May the son of your business rise again. May the son of your head rise again. May the son of your family rise again. May the son of your destiny rise again. Father, we thank you. We bless your name as you go into your word briefly. Go with us. Let your name be glorified. Throw your weight around. Prove to the devil that you are Lord. Take absolute control over this place. By the time you are done, Father, any power that says they will not prosper here, Lord, you bury that power completely. Have your way, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Now quickly, I'll be talking about from sunset to sunrise. When we talk about sunset, what are we saying? It means that what happened, that the sun is going down. And sunset symbolizes what happened. It symbolizes weeping. It symbolizes sorrow. It's another thing for darkness. It's another thing for night. That is why the Bible said in Psalm 30 verse 5, it said, weeping may endure for the night. At the breaking forth of the morning, the joy will spring forth. I don't know if you are going through sunset. It looks as if there's darkness all around you. It looks as if you are going through your evening time. I came to announce to you today, in the name of Jesus, as you say better amen, your darkness will disappear. Your light will appear. Your sun will shine again. It will shine in your marriage. It will shine in your business. It will shine in your finance. It will shine in your health. Wave your hands and shout hallelujah. Sunset. The Bible said there was a man that was going through challenge. They call him Jacob. He has done everything he could. And on a particular day, he said, Lord, I am tired. How long will I go through sunset? And the Bible said he gathered all his family. He said, look, go one place. And they told him a news that his brother that he played for one night, Esau, was looking for him. He came with 400 men waiting for him. If you want to greet your brother, will you come with 400 men? That means he has been waiting for him. He said, the day I will cast Jacob, that's the end. And this man knew that it's only God that can intervene. That in the midst of darkness, they will finish him. But if the sun rises, things will turn. So he went to God and held the hand of God. The Bible said for 7 hours, he was crying, wrestling with God. Lord, change my sunset to sunrise. Change my sunset to sunrise. As he was praying, the angel of God appeared and said to him, what is your name? He said, they called me Jacob. They call me a supplanter. That has been my problem all my life. And then the angel said to him, your name will no longer be called Jacob. Your name will be called Israel. You are now a prince. I have good news for someone. I don't know what name they call you in the spirit realm. They have been calling you. They said, a poor man. So that poor man, because nothing is in your pocket. They saw you and they call you. They say, Mr. Barren or Mrs. Barren. Because you don't have a child to your name. I came to announce to you today. Every name that they gave you in this place now, as you say amen, may God change your name. May God give you a new name. I said, may God give you a new name. You know, God can give a new name. The Bible said that what happened, there was a woman in Luke chapter 1. They called her Elizabeth. And when the angel was speaking to Mary, he said to Mary, he said, your cousin Elizabeth, who was called barren, is with a child 6 months now. So even the angel knew that they were calling her Mrs. Barren. Why? Because she don't have a child. But God changed her name. Do you think that when she gave birth to John the Baptist, her name will change to what happened? Mama John the Baptist. I prophesy, your name will change to favor. Your name will change to prosperity. Your name will change to favor. If you say better amen, God will change your name. I said God will change your name. When we talk about sunrise, We're talking about an end to weeping. We're talking about sunrise. We're talking about having testimony. We're talking about sunrise. We're talking about prosperity. When we talk about sunrise, it means to say your sun begins to shine. That was what happened to this man. By the time he finished the battle, as he stepped out, the sun rose for the first time. I pray for you today, before we leave this place, may your sons begin to shine. May your sun begin to shine. May your sun begin to shine. I don't know if the sun has been going down in your finance. It has been sunset in your finance. The more you put your money in the business, the more the business is going down. That is not the plan for God for your life. God says that what happened in Job chapter 10, verse 1, Job chapter 1, verse 10. He said to Job, the devil was saying, he said to God, he said, you have built a hard edge of fire around him, and you have prospered the works of his hands. You have blessed the work of his hands. So God desired the works of your hands be blessed. So you are not supposed to be investing and yet not seeing what you are investing. Am I talking to someone here today? I pray for you today. Whatever that have been eating your finance, making your job, your store, you have goods before, it's going down. It's going down. It's going down. If you say amen, it's arrested now. Some of you started well. When they settle you, you started well. When your former Oga settled you, you started well. But suddenly you begin to witness sunset. Things started going down. And you are wondering, why will it be going down? That is why God sent me to you today. That is why God sent me here today. To make sure that whatever that is going down, we begin to go up. I said we begin to go up. I said we begin to go up. Can I hear a better amen to that? You might be here today. And you have witnessed sunset in your health. You have been spending money on that sickness all the time, all the time, all the time. And you say, Lord, what is happening to me? How come this sickness refused to go? Listen to me. There's a solution. Jesus is here today to turn it around in the name of Jesus. Before this sermon is over, I see that sickness disappearing. Oh, I say it will leave you by fire. I say it will leave you by fire. Can I hear a better amen to that? Can I hear a resounding amen to that? As I'm just preaching, the Lord just told me about somebody here. There's a man here. You have a wife. And that wife, you have been spending so much money on her. Why? Because she has been sick. And you have been wondering, what is happening? What is happening? What is happening? What is happening? Can I tell you a little secret? Listen to me. There's a power somewhere. A serpent that is eating up your wife. But the Lord, I should tell you today, standing here, you will come and testify that the serpent that has been eating up your wife is dead. If I be a man of God, you will discover as you get home, you will discover your wife is made whole. Is made whole. If you say better, amen, God will perform what he said. So you might be going through sunset. Everything is going down. It could be finance, it could be business, it could be whatever it is. But God has a solution. And God is about to turn it around. Now, I asked my question. You asked me a question. Pastor, even though I'm going through sunset, what is responsible for my sunset? How come I would go through sunset? Why am I going through this thing? You need to understand before you settle the matter. The reason why men could go through sunset, one reason is as a result of what happened of evil men. Evil men. There are some certain men that are so wicked that what happened that they see this man that has a star. They say, you have a star. Why will you be shining? So they are angry that you are shining. And so they get to a place to make some incantation, to make some charm. They get to their occultic gathering, to their coven, to make some charm and make sure that what happened, things are against your life. It happens in the Bible. The Bible said that Jeremiah was weeping to God, Ezekiel, crying and crying, Lord, what is happening? And in the book of what happened, Ezekiel chapter 8, verse 7, that was, the Bible said, and suddenly God appeared to Ezekiel. He said, look at, I will show you. There's a hole in the wall. And he opened that hole. As he peeped in that hole, he saw what happened. Men, 24 elders, they were holding their hands together. They were doing incantation. They say, Ezekiel, you will not succeed. Ezekiel, you will not make it alive. And God said, listen to me. All your prayer sins, these are the people that are responsible. And he took him again to chapter 11 of that scripture. Chapter 11. And then in chapter 11, he got through again. He saw on that set again. This one that set again, Palatia and Chesania. They all combined together and they were doing this. And God said, son, it's time for you to prophesy. And he prophesied. As he prophesied, the Bible said Palatia fell down and died. I prophesy, any wicked one that has value will not prosper. They are there to make you have sunset. Whatever you do, you don't succeed because of their evil work. As you say better amen, they will go down because of you. I said they will go down because of you. Any evil man or woman that need to go down, for God to lift you up. If you say better amen, may God put them down. I said may God put them down. Now if your amen is the ladder, something has started now. If your amen is louder, your neighbor, God is taking over the battle. He's taking over the battle. He's taking over the battle. He's taking over the battle. Wave your hands and shout hallelujah. The works of evil men, they are not happy to see you doing all kinds of things to stop you. They go to their coven. They take a decision. But look at what the Bible says. He said in the book of Isaiah 54, verse 15. He said, they shall gather. They shall surely gather. But not by you, by him. He said, but they that gather because of you, he said, they shall fall. Wherever they are gathering against you, if you say amen, we release thunder. We release fire. We release brimstone. Can I hear a better amen? Can I hear an amen that can open door? Wickedness. Men that are wicked. A sister was prospering some years ago before they brought her. All of a sudden she just woke up and signed, I'm not going to work again. She works in an oil company and they were paying her 1 something million. She just signed, went home, sat home for 2 years, did not know what was happening. On a Sunday morning she woke up. She said, what did she do for village? They said, you know the village. He said, for me, God forbid. I'm not the village. I need to go to work. And they said, you have resigned. You have been at home for 2 years. 2 years. By the time he make a call to his boss, the boss said, you told me, I was begging you. He said, my friend, you are going abroad. You should not disturb me. Hello? So she was bewitched for 2 years. She did not know who she was. She thought that what happened that she just woke up and to go to work. Hello? And by the end of the day, not knowing that what happened, it was her own sister. They said, how come this one will prosper? So they pushed her, she sold everything. It was only that house that was remaining. Because she was not married. Push her. All the money she was using there to train her, what happened at this thing? Her sister, they say. Meanwhile, it was her sister that did that. She did not know until she came. By the time we are praying, the sister started confessing. Can I pray for someone here today? If everyone that is responsible for your darkness or your sunset, if I be a man of God, between now and 21 days, if you say better amen, they shall confess. Somebody shall say confess. Say confess. Say confess. Say confess. Say confess. I prophesy. Any witch or wizard or occultic personality behind your matter, 21 days we give them, they shall confess. I said they shall confess. Number two, what could be responsible for your sunset? Because God is about to turn your sunset to sunrise. Number two, it could be something our as of evil inheritance. Evil inheritance. Have you checked your parents? Have you checked your grandparents? Have you checked your siblings? Others don't succeed. You are the first say, I want to try and succeed. But the powers of your father's house says you don't see anybody succeed here. I used to have a friend in those days that wanted to travel abroad from Okwe. And he took a decision. Pastor, I will travel. I told him, going abroad is not prayer point. He said, pray. It's fasting. Fasting. He fasted so long, so much that what happened that when he wear tie, the tie looked like suicide rope. Because the neck was so thin. Hello? Now, at the point in time, finally, they gave him visa. He traveled out. As he was one day sleeping, somebody just appeared. He saw something like an idol, demon idol appeared. And the idol appeared and called his name. I don't want to call his name. Call his name in Okpe. And ask him in Okpe language. You don't see anybody for your papa. I say, come out. Hey, come America before. But if I come back, oh, we'll call you. And when he got up, he began to speak in tongues. Now, speaking in tongues is not bad. You pray in the spirit. But there are some certain times you pray with understanding. Am I talking to someone here today? So he just spoke in tongues for like 5 minutes, went back to sleep. And 2 days later, police came to his house. That they saw a woman pointing hand at what happened, that they went to thief. And so the CCTV is showing that what happened is the one. It's not me. I'm a pastor. Say, shut up. I've seen pastors that thief. You're not a pastor. I'm not the one. So they bundled him. Hello? Now they were going through the CCTV. The man covered his face, but if you look at his head and everything and whatever, he just looked like this man. And when they were telling me, you know, later on when they send him down, I said, oh boy, what did they pursue plenty of? So you go abroad, you don't look like person being saved, resemble someone being a millionaire, you look like thief. So they were dragging, they were not sure if he's the one, if he's not the one, so he got a good lawyer, and the end of the war happened, they released him and they sent him back to Nigeria. When they send him back to Nigeria, guess what? 2 weeks later, they found the thief. Oh yeah, bro, go back abroad now. Now lie. Up to this I'm saying that this thing happens around 80 something. Up to now, this thing happened about 89. Up to now, the guy could not go. Am I talking to someone here today? I don't know any power from your father's house that says nobody except in your family. And because of that, you try to excel. After some time, you go down. If you say better, amen, may fire settle the matter. I say, may fire settle the matter. Lift your say, my father, as I begin to pray, any power from my father's house or my mother's house that used to limit men, I am not your candidate. In the name of Jesus. Die! 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 Open your mouth and talk to God. 1 minute. I am not your candidate. Receive fire. In Jesus' name we pray. Have you discovered the same thing that happened to your sister happened to you? The same thing happened to your brother happened to you? The Lord just told me about someone here today. He said there's a person here that will have in your family of three sons, you have lost 3 persons. And not just the 3, others have died. But of three sons, not too long this year, you have lost 3 persons. There have been untimely death in your family. The Lord said, I should congratulate you because you are here today. That starting from now, take note that death trend has come to an end in the name of Jesus. If you say better amen, you will live to testify. I said you will live to testify. I said you will live to testify. So maybe your family, there's a particular sickness. Everybody's sick. And that has brought a sunset in your health. Am I talking to someone here today? Listen to me. Can I announce to someone? The reason why records are set, records are dear, records are meant to be broken. Can I talk to someone here today? If they have been in your family before and someone has drawn a line
and say, by the reason of this line, nobody cross this line in the family. Either you try to cross it, they draw you back. Or you refuse, they say, we kill you. I prophesy, if you say a better amen, God will use you to break that record. I said, God will use you to break that record. That line they say you will not cross, you will cross that line. If nobody has been a multi-billionaire or a multi-millionaire in your father's house, you shall be the first. Starting from now, God will turn around your finance. He will turn around your business. Turn around everything that has to do with you. If you say a better amen, it will come to pass. Thirdly, why is it that what happened, a man with weakness sunset? It could be that the man himself costed himself. It could be a cause of it. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 2, from verse 1 to 10, the Magi, you know, you call them three wise men. They are not three wise men. They are the Magi, you know. But they brought three gifts. The wise men. The Bible said that what happened, that they what? They went to see, look for Jesus. They saw the star shining. And they came on the way, 1,400 kilometers from Babylon, because they saw a star. And that reminds me, can I tell you, anyone that saw your star and they want to cover your star, may the fire of God consume them. I didn't hear a better amen to that. May your star fight against your enemies. I didn't hear a resounding amen to that. Now listen to me so I can work this out. They entered the place, and as they entered, something happened. They discovered all of a sudden, after talking with Aaron, they saw that what happened, that the star disappeared. They could not find the star again. But the Bible said when they came out of the place, they saw the star and they began to rejoice. Listen to me. You may have gone into a place you ought not to go. Your star disappeared. You may be here today and you have joined court. As the Lord is ministering to me, to someone now, you went to join court so that you can get money. But look at your life. You started well and you start having money. Look at your life. Your life is sick. You are sick now. As I'm saying, you are very sick. And as I'm saying now, your business is going down. It's going down. They have come to collect it. But today, God is giving you a chance. As you decide to walk out, I prophesy, may God take care of your health and may God take over your business. Can I hear a better amen to that? Now, can I hear an amen that can bring testimony? So, you may have entered a place, and because where you go, your star disappeared. They might give you a charm and say, put this charm there. And you put that charm there and look at your life. What happened? Darkness came all over again. Instead of light, darkness all over the place. Am I talking to someone? You might have stepped into a serious sin and darkness just come over you. And you say, Lord, where is the sun? The sun is there, but the problem is that why would darkness cover the sun? Am I talking to someone here today? Anytime there's a storm, you ask yourself, where? I've asked myself a question one time. And I said, where is the sun? The sun is there. It is the cloud that covered it. When the storm is over, the cloud will clear. The sun will shine. I have good news for you today. Get ready. Darkness is about to dispatch for light to appear. I can't hear a better amen to that. Now, I can't hear an amen that brings testimony. Now, because you entered yourself, you need to walk out yourself. I pray for you today as you take a decision to walk out. Say, Lord, I want to surrender to you. I want to come to you. I prophesy. As you say a better amen, may God turn things around. May God turn things around. May God turn things around. If God could turn the things around in the life of what happened to Jacob, despite all his mistakes he made. After that day, immediately Esau saw him. Esau began to embrace him. My brother started crying. And all the men around Esau was looking and said, what is wrong with Esau? For how many years you have been boasting? For 20-something years, Because he spent 7, 7, that is what happened, that is 14, and then another 6 years. Again, that's 20 years. He spent in the house of Laban. Hello? So for 20 years, Jacob and Esau have been moving around the borders, around the place, put his men on guard. The day we see Jacob, we'll cut off his neck. But when he had the encounter, as the sun came, his face began to shine. The Shekinah glory came upon him. And when he saw him, his heart made up of stone melted. He had the heart of flesh. He said, my brother, and he started weeping. Now all the people around him was wondering, what is happening? At this hour, our God, the boss, and said, if you see Jacob, go kill him. Not knowing that what happened. Because Jacob has weakness, sunrise. There's someone here today. I prophesy. You are about to witness sunrise. You are moving from sunset to sunrise. I didn't hear a better amen to that. Now you ask me, Pastor, what can I do? Because we will pray. We need to pray. What can I do? Or what will I do for me to witness sunrise again? The very first thing first is to give your life to Christ. Give your life to Christ. I will explain on that. The second thing is for you to cry unto God. Call upon God himself. It's only him. Let no man deceive you. There's no power that can save except that of God. There's nothing. You try here, is a lie. No man can save you except God himself. If you can, God can arise on your behalf. Be sure of that matter. That will be settled. So these are the two things you need to do today. First, if you are in sin, repent. Secondly, if you are not giving your life to Christ or you are keeping your hands on, repent today. And then we will cry. Now let me tell you a story. There was this man. This man had a farm. He was the owner of the farm. And as the owner of the farm, what did he do? He employed a manager. An employed gate man and other people take over. So they did that. And one day, the manager was hungry. He had a poultry. The farm's a poultry. He had a poultry. You know? And the manager was hungry. I said, one day, I want to eat. And he looked at his life. How can I be working in a place and not eating something? I need to take something. This is Christmas period. Let me just... I may be manager after all. So, he took 2 birds, 5 birds, you know, chicken, put it inside his boot, lock it. He didn't take it, he stole it. This is the worst. Take. he stole it. So, as he was going, the gate man said, stop. He said, what do you mean? Stop. I'm the manager of this place. Well, he said, sir, there's a normal routine. Stop and check. He said, but you have not been stopping me since. He said, listen to me, I want to check. Sir, you are not, this is a rule that has been in this place for the how many years? So I will check. And so they started, you know, dragging, the man closed the gate. He said, oh God, you need to go. So at the end of the day, what happened? They opened the boot and they got the chicken. Hey! Look at, manager, you don't thief. He said, I beg, no tell them. Hey, I beg. And the gate man said, so what are we going to do? He said, now, we are going to cut a deal. First thing first, this chicken, I will confiscate the chicken. It will be in my this thing. You will not talk. Then number two also, anytime I send you a message, you must... obey. He said, no problem. It's okay. So took it. So anytime the manager is coming, and the manager comes, he said, the gate man said, sir, please, please, I won't go see my brother. If you have mistaken it. The manager said, okay. He said, okay. So anytime I said, cheat, the manager remembers, okay, good. So people now come say, manager, what are you doing in the gate? He said, you know, some law of leadership. You have to be a servant. You know, this servant leadership, you know, so I have to serve, you know, so I'm helping They get mad. Now, people did not know what was happening. But they came, people begin to, this thing is fishy. How can? So anytime he's coming, he say, sir, I want to go and say, he said, hey, so the thing was so much that this man started crying. And one day he said to himself, let me go and meet the owner. If I can report myself to the owner of this business, I think there will be a change. If he sacked me, let him sack me. But this torment is too much. The blackmail is too much. And what did he do? He ran to meet the man. As he got there, he told the man said, hey, manager, I trusted you. You can do this kind of thing. Still. He said, I'm sorry, let down. And the man looked at him. He said, listen to me. He said, can I tell you this? I've not found anyone as faithful as you. He said, others will steal. They will not come and say they're thief. But you came and confessed that you stole 2 chickens. And you don't even eat the chicken because the gate man stole it from you again. Thief. It's a sign that something pushed you to do that. And if you can be under well, you will not do it again. He says, sir, I swear I will not do it again. And then the man said, I'm looking for someone because to handle over this thing to be the MD. I just want to rest. And I've been thinking, who is faithful to handle this position? Because it's a sensitive position. And I said, okay, since you came to confess, they come. From now henceforth, you'll be the MD of the company. Can we jam my hands to the Lord? Now, come and look at the problem now. By the time they made him the MD, one day he was just coming again. And the man said, please. I want to go see my girlfriend. Stay at the gate and say, my friend, what do you mean? My friend disappeared. He said, chit. The man said, this is not the work again. And the gate man said, what? So he ran to go and meet the owner of the company. He said, Oga, that your gate man said, that your manager said, point of correction. MD, it's okay, call her MD or this, but the man a thief. The man stole your chicken 2 years ago. Now I can't call report. And the guy said, man, you are a thief. You are supposed to be a gate man. The thief stole. You did not come to report. You stole from the thief. You are a bigger thief. So now I sack you. Can you jam your hands to the Lord? Now, is that not a wonderful story? But can I tell you what that represents? The gate man in question is the devil, the accuser of the brethren. The one that happens to be the manager became the MD is you and I. There are some things in your life that you have done, and the accuser, the gate man, is accusing you, blackmailing you. Now you are living below your potential. Meanwhile, you ought to be promoted. But the Lord is saying, if you can come to me and confess your sin before me and ask for forgiveness, instead of you being demoted, I will lift you up. I will promote you. And the Lord is saying to someone here today that need to take a decision. You don't need to be shy. You don't need to be wobbling, whatever it is. We all took all this decision. In fact, in my own time, there were so many crowd. I had to take a decision to come out. When I see something, nobody tell me before I give my life with my 2 hands at the Wakati call. Because I know where I'm coming from. There did nobody advise me. As the man of God was preaching that time, years ago, I raised my hand up. I'm coming. This is me. I don't need anybody. That's me. I never knew that what happened. One day God will use me to change lives. And that's what God wants to do for someone here today. Now, wherever you are under the sound of my voice, either you are in your store, either you are in your house, or you are in the office, or you are here today, and you are hearing the sound of my voice, the Lord is speaking to you now. You want to give your life to Christ? You want to rededicate your life to Christ? You say, Lord, I am tired of what I'm going through. I need a change in my life, Lord. I can see you are the only one that can turn my life around. Wherever you are, all head bowed, just say after me, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Cancel my name in the book of death. Write my name in the book of life. Lord, I don't want to remain the same. Father, turn my life around for good, oh Lord. Let me have testimony. Today, Lord, starting from now, let situation change. Thank you, Father, because now I'm born again. Now you pray that prayer with me, whatever you have. I want to pray with you myself. Please come forward. Don't be shy. Come. Come this way. Come this way. You are taking a decision. Come. Quick. I'm calling you. Either you are outside, inside, wherever. Come. This is what God called you. God came here. Lord came because of you. Come. Wherever you are, just come. Come this place. Wherever. Left, right, wherever. Come. Quick, quick, quick. The Lord is knocking on your heart. Don't hide in your heart today. This is an opportunity. It's between you and God, not between you and man. Where you are coming, come. God is calling you. If you are there looking at me, don't harden your heart. Don't waste your time. God is about to change your life for good. Come now. He's knocking on the door. He's knocking on the door of your life. Come, my brother. Come, my sister. Come. You don't need to kneel down. If you want to kneel down, you can kneel down. But he's not coming to kneel down. Come. If you are coming, come. 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 The Lord is calling you. Come. 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 Talk to God. Come. I'm still waiting for some persons now. Yes, there's someone that is taking a decision. Should I come or should I not come? Join them. Quick, I'm waiting. Before it's too late. God sent me to this place because of you. It's not because of anyone, but because of you. And God wants to bring a change in your life. My brother, come. My sister, come. Before it's too late. Before it's too late. Before it's too late. Anything can happen. Anything can happen. Don't let the plan of the enemy come to pass in your life, because God wants to bring a change. I'm waiting for you now, because it's time. We want to pray now. We want to pray now. We want to pray now. So come, come, come. If I count five, you're not yet here, we will close it. And it is you and God. And on the day of judgment, God will ask you, you were here when I sent my servant to come and preach to you. You refuse to come. Please don't miss that. I'm counting now. One, if you are there, come. Two, come. Put in the focus. If you are coming, come, 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 come. Three, if you are coming, come, 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 come. Four, I want to count five now. I'm rapping around up. Thank you, Father. If you are coming, just come. Join them, join them, join them. Father, we want to thank you for this, your sisters. We want to thank you for your sons that have taken a decision. I pray that your hand will be upon them. Cancel their name in the book of death. Write their name in the book of life. Let their life never remain the same. Let them live here with testimony. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Now lift your hands and say, Father, I give you praise. I have about four or five prayers and make a declaration and something will happen. Just give him praise. Give him adoration. Thank him. Super blood of Jesus, come and deliver me. Precious blood of Calvary, I say, come and deliver. Super blood of Jesus, come and deliver. I say, blood of Calvary, I say, come and deliver me. 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 Now lift up your hands and say, my Father, my Father, my Father. Oh, blood of Jesus, arise with your weapon of war. Go to my foundation. Get to my Father's house. Come to my business. Arise. Deliver me. Deliver me. Deliver me. Open your mouth and talk to God. Call upon the blood. Set me free. Oh, blood of Jesus, set me free. Set me free. Set me free. 1 minute to pray that prayer quickly. Set me free. Set me free. Set me free. Oh, yes. Talk to God. Talk to God. Set me free. Set me free. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are going to lift up and say, my Father, as I pray now, whatever that needs to live my life, so that I will move forward, what are you waiting for? In the name of Jesus, get out of my life. Out, 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 out. Get out. Whatsoever that needs to live my life, for me to move forward. Oh yeah, pack a load, walk out. Walk out of my life. 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 Lift up your voice and talk to God. Begin to walk out. Begin to walk out. Begin to walk out. Out, 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 out. Talk to God. Walk out by fire.
Hallelujah.
Walk out by fire. Walk out, walk out, walk out, walk out, walk out, walk out. In Jesus' name we pray. Now 4 more prayer points and we're done. You are going to lift up your voice. You are going to pray every padlock of darkness that the enemy used to lock your store. Can I tell you something? A sister in our fellowship one day came. She stays in Agbaru. And she came to me and said, Daddy, say yes. He said, sir, blood. Stain. And I came in and the curtain was full with blood. I said, who will do this on her? And I locked the house. So that's how she said. So, she took the curtain, washed the curtain, cleaned the blood, and opened her store. Now, for 3 months, that place that used to be, people used to rush. Nobody came. Nobody came. They would just pass. I said, sorry. They passed. They were just passing her. And she came to meet me. Said, Daddy, I don't know what's happening. I said, you don't have understanding. How can you see blood? You just say, what did you say? You just say, maybe a mistake. Everything is same. It's okay. Oh, by Jesus. That's all. Hello? And then you go and put it there. So, I pray with her. Say, go. So, she got anointing oil. We pray on it. She anointed the place. She said, as she anointed that place, as she opened the store, people started coming. They said, Mother, so. What happened? You closed your store. See? He said, no. He said, it's not a lie. With the past year since, you locked the store. He said, no locker. They said, you lock him. She said, I didn't lock it. So they were arguing with her. So when they were driving past, they would see the store locked. Meanwhile, physically, it's open. Spiritually, they have locked it. Am I talking to someone here today? So it's possible that they can lock a man's business. Hello? One of our sisters in one of these markets there, what happened? She came for one of our all nights, and guess what? She said she didn't know. She has never sold. She said for close 6 months, nobody has come to her store. So they said, come to the program. So she came. She said she was sharing a testimony. She said, in the course of the program, after the program, she now relaxed before she could go because it was already early in the morning, about 4 we finished or so. So she slept in the hall, and by the time she woke up, she had a dream. And in that dream, she said she saw a store. They took tarpaulin. Rubber tarpaulin. They covered it. Covered it. He said he saw a man with white. That's an angel. Came in and said, come. Can't you see that they cover your store? That's why you're not selling. So they tore it. He said by the time they were chilling, he said when the whole place, it will fool this market. He said what came out of it? Through this market. He said, the man got some message. Don't worry. He said, no, don't worry. He set it on fire. And when the burn it finished, he called a wind. The wind came, blew it. He said, go. She woke up, went to her store. For the first time, all her goods finished. All are good. I'm telling you.
She's in this there. What do they call this store here now? Main market.
All are good. Finish. That is how God started opening. Biggie people, things have changing your life. Listen to me today as you pray this prayer point. Whatever they used to lock your store, lock your hand, lock your destiny, it will break by fire. Now lift your hands up to God. Say, my father, as I begin to pray, in the name of Jesus, every witchcraft padlock that they used to lock my store, lock my hands, lock my destiny, lock my marriage, lock my health. As I pray now, all ye padlock, what are you waiting for? Break, 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 break. My sister, break the padlock. My brother, break the padlock. Release your store. Release your business. Release your destiny. Release your health. Lift up your voice. Yes. Break it. 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 Lift up your voice and talk to God. 1 minute to pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now you will speak to your star before the last prayer point. Are you ready now? You will speak to your star. O ye star of my destiny, hear the word of the Lord. Where are you? What are you doing in that hiding place? What are you doing in that coven where they kept you? What are you doing in that place that they cover you? I command you now, escape, manifest, begin to shine. Listen to me, there are some safety connection you ought to get that will take you to the top. No man is an island, you need connections. Can I talk to someone here today? Hello? Do you know when God, listen to me, God believes in connection, divine connection. When God wanted to use Moses, he saw that Moses came from a very poor family. God is too much. Clap your hands for God, I beg. He came from a poor family. And God said, listen to me, this man, number one, he's going to write the Pentateuch, the 5 books of the Bible. That's number one. Number two, this man is going to lead Israel from bondage. It means to say that what happened, he must learn the art of war. Now, is it that poor family that I want to train him? So, even though Pharaoh was looking for him to kill, he was still in the will of God. Can I talk to someone here today? It was in the will of God that Pharaoh would pursue him. To his place of breakthrough. If not, if he has remained in his father's house, he would have moved. So the Bible said the mother got him and covered him. By the time he covered him, he saw that he could no longer hold him again, cover him again. This guy became so big. He could not be covered. The man said, release him. As they released him, they took him, put him, get basket, put what you call it, they say borishes, hello, and slime, and they put him there. Now, and that this thing was infested with crocodiles. That river, hello, infested river Nile, crocodiles. Now that day, God sent the crocodiles on assignment. Everybody go and fast. So they were fasting. Hello, now look at connection. Someone say connection. Pharaoh's wife. They used to bath in swimming pool. Where's the latest river here? The latest river here. Where's the new river? What? This river here. Ogbujo River. Now, Pharaoh, that is a king, and the daughter baths in swimming pool. He doesn't mean say, he said, see, since all my life, I know I come bath for Ogbujo River. They said, he said, all this dirty water at times, you need to experience that. Every time you go there, I mean, with the palace, they will go experience one for that river. Not knowing that it was a divine arrangement that brings about divine connection. Because connection is coming to you this time, oh. After this program, you shall be divinely connected. The Bible said that what happened, and he came in, and by the time he got there, that baby begin to cry. What did they cry here? And God shut her womb. This got too much. He closed her womb, said, you don't go get picking. So that she can appreciate that. As he saw that, was there, bring up. And they carried the child. Did I ask and say, you need best of love? He said, yes. See how God do. They had to carry a mother, pay mama to train her. Clap your hands for this God. It's too much. It's too much. Pay mama to come take care of her. Now, your own enemy, they were training the man that will destroy them. They trained him to the best school and took him to the heart of war. They sent him an assignment. He was fighting war for Pharaoh, for Egypt, winning battle. He never lost any battle. God was saying, I'm training you to get to that level. Until the time for the manifestation. I pray for you today. Listen to me. Your star needs to shine for people to see you. Helpers want to help you, but they cannot see you because you are darkness around. If they pass you, they don't know nothing of you. Can I talk to someone here today? But when this your star begins to shine, they are running to you. Oh yeah, more will help you. More will help you. More will help you. Literally, and say, oh, ye star of my destiny. Enough is enough. Wherever you are hiding, wherever you have covered, wherever you have been covered, either in the cupboard, either under the water, in my father's house, in my mother's house, hear the word of the Lord. Escape. Manifest. Begin to shine. 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 Open your mouth and tell God, command the star, begin to shine. Begin to shine. For the world to see. Shine. Let my helpers locate me. Shine. Let favor locate me. Shine. Let my story change. Shine, 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 shine. Open your mouth and tell God. In Jesus' name we pray. Final prayer point before I make a declaration. You will lift up your voice and you are going to shout it loud and clear. You will cry, my long awaited breakthrough. My long awaited testimony. My long awaited miracle. Hear the word of the Lord. What are you waiting for? In the name of Jesus, manifest by fire. Are you ready now? Lift your hands to God. Say, my long awaited testimony. My long awaited breakthrough. My long awaited miracle. Hear the word of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. What are you waiting for? Manifest by fire. Open your mouth and turn to God. Manifest, 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 manifest. Lift up your voice. Manifest. Talk to God as we begin to round up. Manifest by fire. 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 Talk to God. Manifest. In Jesus' name we pray. Please, can you lift up your right hand of dominion, right hand of authority? As you lift up your hands, I lift my right hands with you. I join my faith with your faith. I decree that starting from now, any power that vowed that you will never prosper in life, may the fire of God consume them in the name of Jesus. Every curse that says you will labor and you will not see the fruit of your labor, may the curse be broken now in the name of Jesus. Every power or evil person that has been sitting on your star, I unseat them now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every anyone's business in this place. I command Ephrata, be open. I command your soul, Ephrata, be open. 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 Whoever it is that has said that the store that will make a decree, that we go back to close the store. The Bible says, when God opens a door, no man can shut that door. Whoever that dare vow to close the door that God has opened for you, as you say, better amen, may they receive fire. 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 I decree starting from now, whatever you lay your hands on, it will begin to prosper. It will begin to prosper. Every calamity, every problem the enemy has set before you, it is back to sender. It is back to sender. It is back to sender. I pray for you today. Any man or woman, evil power that need to go down, for your testimony to be full. If you say better amen, they go down now. I said they go down now. I said they go down now. I said they go down now. I speak to your business, begin to prosper. Begin to prosper. Begin to prosper. I command customers to begin to come. I open the door wide. Let them begin to come. From the east, from the west, from the north, from the south. All over worry, beyond worry. Let them begin to come. In the mighty name of Jesus. For the first time in your life, I make a declaration. The kind of sales you have never witnessed. For the next how many days, next how many weeks, you will begin to experience it in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for the market as a whole. I decree that this market will go places in Jesus' name. Very soon, even abroad, they will be hearing the news of this market. People will be coming from far and wide. It will be like a place where happen. They say this is the main place. Just as people are traveling to Dubai to buy things, people will be coming to this market to buy things from all over the country. I pray for the prosperity of this market. I decree that whatever, I rebuke any form of crisis in the name of Jesus. I come mighty against any form of fire outbreak. I rebuke disaster. It shall be far. Every contrary power ruling over this place, I take authority over them. I dislodge them. I dislodge them. I dislodge them. I enthrone Christ in this market. I enthrone Christ in your store. I proclaim the lordship of Jesus over this market, over your life, over your business, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for your families. Every family present here, I pray for your family. I pray for prosperity. I rebuke sickness. I speak health. Where there's untimely death, that yoke is broken. That command is broken. No more untimely death. Where you are sick in your family or your body, I say be healed now. 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 Starting from now, any strong man that be ruling in your family before, that strong man has been dislodged now. We bind that strong man. We break that stronghold. Every evil pattern that used to operate, that says, like father, like son, as the papa suffer, now so Pekin go suffer. I break it in your life. I release you from that yoke. You are different from your father. You are different from your sister. Your destiny is different. You will live to fulfill your destiny. I agree with you. I pray for your roots. Where you came from. Your village. Your community. I bless it now. I decree that what happened, that there shall be prosperity there. You came from that root. in the name of Jesus, you shall be proud of that place you came from. Not only proud, but they shall be proud of you. God will use you to set that your community, your village on the map for people to see. When they look at you, they say, we don't know this place. They say, don't you know this man? Now this place he come from. So through you, even your small community that men did not know, they will begin to know it. God will use you to put a map in the world. People will know it because of your exploit. I decree it will come to pass. It will come to pass. As you go for your normal business, as you go to buy things and come back, may God give you joy and mercy. You will not be up. You will not have accidents. Any car you will want to enter that will have accident, as you are about to enter, may the Holy Ghost draw your leg. May you not enter that vehicle. The day that you will travel and they say, we will kill this person, on that day, may the Holy Ghost hold you from traveling. Go and fulfill your destiny. Go and prosper. Go and make it. In the name of God the Father. In the name of God the Son. In the name of God the Holy Ghost. Now you believe that God has answered prayer. Wave your hands and shout hallelujah.
We believe you've been richly blessed and inspired by the living word of God, delivered by Pastor John Okene. We invite you to worship with us live at Divine Church International Ministries, where the anointed servant of God, Pastor John Okene, will be teaching and preaching the undiluted word of God with signs and wonders. Worship with us this Sunday. First service, 8 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Second service, 9:30 a.m. to 11 a.m. What's more, join us every Thursday for our interdenominational power-packed Divine Church program, which takes place by 10:30 a.m. It's one meeting you can't afford to miss. Venue, Divine Church International Ministries, situated at Paradise Hall, Mosheshe Estate, off Airport Road, Efrun, Delta State, Nigeria. For prayers and counseling, reach us on 081-359-526-23. 081-359-526-23. God bless you.